I grew up in a house with parents that worked in the theater. My mother was actually a costume designer, and my father was a set designer. I guess I was about 16 when I had my first job in the costume shop at the Public Theater in New York City. I would walk Linda Ronstadt's dog while she had her fitting. I spray painted shoes, I did returns, and I got paid $98 a week.
I've always thought of myself as a people person.
I went on to college where I was a fine arts major. I was thinking I was going to be a painter. And I always say it's a bit like the mafia. You know, I tried to get out, but they pulled me back in.
I wish we were yuppies. Young, upwardly mobile, professional. Those are good things, not bad things.
Last Days of Disco was one of my first movies. Whit Stillman was directing. It was loosely based on Studio 54, but it really lived in the world of Whit Stillman. So he never really wanted to do the sort of more ostentatious, fun, kind of vulgar side of disco. Everything was very restrained, and living by Whit's memory almost of how his friends were at the time. In 1998, I went out to Los Angeles to do Jack Frost. One of the interesting parts about working on Jack Frost was working with the snowman. We had a woman who hand-knit the scarf to the dimensions that we needed, and then we had a milliner build this enormous hat, which was a copy of Michael Keaton's hat.
Oh!
Every movie is a challenge, and there's so many challenges. Recreating the Macy's Day Parade for Tower Heist, recreating the Halloween Parade in New York for Ninja Turtles 2, recreating the United Nations, and also just the challenges of individual characters. In The Secret Life of Walter Mitty, Ben wanted there to be a difference between the fantasy Walter and the real life Walter. So we made subtle adjustments to the costumes that I'm not even sure the viewer is aware of. Everything was a little bit more fitted in the fantasy sequences. The color of the pants was darker. The color of the shirt was a little bluer, just to sort of tweak Walter so that he was more attractive and sort of more heroic in all of the fantasy sequences. Salt was originally written for a man, and when it changed and it was rewritten for Angelina, she really wanted to hold on to a lot of the male elements of the character. And instead of being a Bond girl kind of spy, she wanted to be Bond. You know, the big sequence where she's in the black coat and the trousers. We decided she swiped those clothes off a dry cleaning rack, which happens in the scene in the movie, for the other big chase scene with the truck and like jeans and boots, real things that a spy would wear in those circumstances. And all of those things really helped to inform that character. When I'm working with actors, I like to start by having a conversation with them, bringing in a sketch or a research board, and really try to nail down what it is we want to say about this character through the clothes.
I must say, Igby, you have perfected the hobo look.
And then we put the things on the body. Something might look great on a hanger, but it doesn't really work on the actor. It's ultimately sort of whittling away and narrowing it down until you find something that brings that character alive for the actor. You know, I really love being able to help them find that character and own that.
What's with the hat?
Here we go. It's train to rock around, that's right, on time, it's train.